You know, as much as I love HTC Sense, I think it's made some great evolutionary improvements from where it was when it first started all the way up to Sense 4 Plus. But you know what? With 1 gigabyte of RAM, it still needs some work in the lag department. I'm Aaron Baker from PhoneDog.com. This is day 9 with the HTC One X Plus. 9 days in, the HTC One X Plus still needs some work in the lag department. You know, Sense 4 Plus has seen some significant evolutionary upgrades from where it was in the Sense 3.5 days and the Sense 3 days, but I still find that even though it's relatively responsive on the home screens and things like that, I find that when I go into detailed areas, I just see a little bit of lag, much like right there, how it took a second to go into the settings. Now, that may not seem like much, but when you consider the fact that this phone is powered by a quad-core 1.7 gigahertz NVIDIA Tegra 3 CPU, you can see that that gets a little bit old. And even though HTC said they pared back on some of those kind of obtrusive notifications and obtrusive spinning and twisting and all those different animations that we saw in Sense 3 and 3.5, there are still some times where I'm like, you know what? It's still just ever so slightly bloated in comparison to some of the competitors on the market. Motorola's UI, TouchWiz, LG's user interface, and of course, stock Android. So you can see here, of course, you got little things like this, which is nice. It's kind of effect where you scroll up, and you get some space in between the icons, but you can still see from time to time there's a periodic lag. You go in, you can see it takes a second for it to load up, and I just find that throughout using applications and nothing too graphically intensive or heavy, I find that maybe using email or browsing the web from time to time, it's a little bit laggy periodically. That's something to keep in mind. You know, the 2 gigabyte of RAM packing Droid DNA, I don't see it as much. I think Sense can run just fine on 2 gigabytes of RAM, but I would love to see it run just fine on 1 gigabyte of RAM. Considering this is a high-end device on AT&T, you'd expect for it to run relatively smoothly. That is not knocking this device by any means. There's still a lot to like about this device, namely the 64 gigabytes of internal storage. The camera is fantastic. They bumped it up to a 2,100 milliamp hour battery, which I'm finding 9 days in is incredibly nice on standby time. Still needs a little bit of work when it comes to actual use time. Just to give you an idea, I've worked with this all day long. Combination of standby, it's been on my desk and I've been at work, so I've been using my desk phone. But combination of work and standby time, it's at 69% at 3:24 in the afternoon. It was pulled off the charger this morning about 7:30. So keep that in mind. You know, it's not the best battery in the world. And if you're coming from the Note 2 or the Droid Razr HD Max, something with a big 3,000 plus milliamp hour battery, you're probably going to see that battery life isn't quite as good as it could be. Now, wallpaper, for example, you're just seeing a little bit of stutter. It feels like it's not as optimized with Android as it should be, and that's something that concerns me. Sense 4 Plus is beautiful. It's graphically beautiful. You can see the widgets look fantastic, but I just find from time to time it's a little bit slow and stuttery. We'll go into Google Play Books, just for example. Scroll through some of these and take a look. Watch by HTC. Let's go to one. Stocks, maybe. There we go. And we can bring these over to the home screen and bring it over to this empty home screen just so you can see. And you can see even then there's a little bit of stutter on the actual home screen pan out. So let's do a quadrant standard test and take a look. And this is where it kind of fools you because of that quad-core 1.7 gigahertz Tegra 3 CPU. It's nice and fast all around, and quadrant standard tends to perform relatively well. But that said, the 1 gigabyte of RAM I do find slows the overall processes throughout the day. And just so you know, this is in response to a question that was asked to me on YouTube. So be sure to hit me with your questions that you have about the One X Plus throughout this 30-day challenge at phonedog_Aaron on Twitter and on Facebook at facebook.com/HiAaronBaker. So quadrant standard's running. Like I said, battery life's been somewhat decent. I find, again, that in use times it's pretty heavy, but standby time is quite good. I do like the way this device feels in the hand overall, though I will say I don't care for the design. I much prefer kind of the boxy industrial design of the Evo 4G LTE or the design of the Galaxy S3 or the Note 2, the iPhone 5. Don't really care for this, despite the fact the polycarbonate shell is incredibly nice and a lot of people really enjoy it. So 7,497 on quadrant standard tells you that this device looks fast on the surface and that Tegra 3 processor is quite nice, but I wish they had put 2 gigabytes of RAM in this flagship device for AT&T. Keep it locked on PhoneDog.com for continuing coverage as I move along with the 30-day challenge of the HTC One X. Tweet me your questions at PhoneDog_Aaron or on Facebook at Facebook.com/HiAaronBaker. Got plenty more times, to shoot video, plenty more days in the 30-day challenge. I would love to hear from you on Twitter or on Facebook. Keep it locked on the site for continuing coverage of the One X Plus 30-day challenge. And as always, we'll see you next time.